While we do our best to make sure NordVPN runs smoothly, sometimes things don't work as expected. In this video, we will give you some tips on how to solve NordVPN connection problems. But before we move on, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for our latest content. So here are a few steps you should take if NordVPN doesn't connect for you. Number 1. Check if your account is active. Make sure you paid all the subscription fees and that your account isn't suspended. Also, keep in mind that your account can be inactive due to the fee processing of different payment systems. Payments via credit card and iDEAL may take up to 40 minutes to be verified, while the verification of fees paid via coin payments may take up to 24 hours. Payments can also get wrongly flagged for suspicions of fraud, but in these cases, it will get back to your credit card soon. Number 2. If your account is active, try switching between different protocols and servers. Some servers can reject new connections if they're overloaded, but NordVPN offers you tons of servers to choose from, so try a different one. Also, our Quick Connect function will automatically choose the best server for you. You can try switching between the UDP and TCP protocols. While they both have their pros and cons, UDP is usually faster than TCP. However, this comes at the cost of stability. You can change them in the general section of the NordVPN app preferences next to the VPN protocols option. NordVPN also offers a few tunneling protocols, which have their pros and cons, so try different ones to see which is the best for you. Number 3. Reset or reinstall the app. For resetting the app on Windows, you should open the settings by pressing the cogwheel icon in the upper right corner. Then, choose Advanced and click Run Diagnostics Tool. In the window that opens, select Reset App. If you use Android, iOS, or macOS, simply try reinstalling the app. Number 4. You can also try changing DNS servers to Cloudflare DNS ones. But please note that these DNS servers are not provided by NordVPN and thus should be used at your own discretion. DNS changing workflow differs depending on your operating system. In Windows, you should right-click the network icon or the Wi-Fi icon if you are connected to Wi-Fi in the taskbar notification area and select Network and Sharing Center. Then select Change Adapter Options, right-click on the Wi-Fi or Ethernet adapter that you use to connect to the internet and choose Properties. Then select Internet Protocol Version 4, TCP/IPv4, and click Properties. Select Use the following DNS server addresses and enter Cloudflare DNS addresses. In the Preferred DNS Server field, enter 1.1.1.1, while in the Alternative DNS Server field, enter 1.0.0.1, then click OK. Also, repeat the same steps for the Tap NordVPN Windows adapter. On macOS, go to System Preferences, click Network, then select the interface of the network you use and click Advanced. Then open the DNS tab, click the plus button, enter 1.1.1.1 and 1.0.0.1 and click OK. For Linux, open the terminal by clicking Ctrl plus T. When there, enter SU to become a root user. Once you enter a root password, enter the commands you see in the video. When the text editor opens, type the lines you see in the video, save the file, and close the editor. In the terminal, type another string of commands you see on the screen, and you're done. On Android, go to Settings, select Connections, and pick Wi-Fi. Next to your current network, press the cog icon and choose Advanced. When there, change your IP settings to Static. In the DNS1 and DNS2 fields, enter 1.1.1.1 and 1.0.0.1 respectively, and tap Save. Also, make sure to enter the grayed out values too. Then, disconnect from the network and reconnect for the changes to take effect. On iOS, it's pretty straightforward too. Just open Settings, tap on Wi-Fi, pick a Wi-Fi network, and tap on the blue I icon. Then choose Configure DNS and select Manual. Tap Add Server and type in 1.1.1.1 and 1.0.0.1. Then click Save. Number 5. Make sure to make exceptions for NordVPN in your antivirus software. In some cases, your security software might block VPN connections, so make sure to whitelist all NordVPN-related connectivities. I hope these tips will help you to solve all the connection issues. If not, our customer support team is always available for help. Stay safe, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave a comment below. NordVPN, online security starts with a click. Liked our video? Make sure to check these ones.